गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू आर ऑल वेल एंड फाइन एट होम. यस, ओके. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ न्यू वीडियो ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 5, दैट इज अडेप्टेशन इन प्लांट्स. सो इन द लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट चैप्टर नंबर 4, दैट वॉज इन अडेप्टेशन इन एनिमल्स. नाउ दिस इज अ न्यू वीडियो एंड इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट हाउ टू प्लांट्स अडेप्ट इन द डिफरेंट सिचुएशन. So in this chapter, we are going to learn about adaptation in plants, terrestrial plants, and what are the different kind of aquatic plants. Okay, so let's start. Just a second. Okay. We cannot grow all the plants in pots. So it is very difficult. We cannot grow all the pots in plants. It is not possible. Different plants grow in different habitats. So habitat means they are the natural living place. Like we have already discussed in the previous chapter, the natural living place of an animals. Now the natural living place of a plant, that is described as a habitat. These habitats are places such as deserts. जैसे कि कुछ habitats हैं जहाँ पे plant deserts में पाए जाते हैं, in mountains, in plains and in water. Also the plants of different habitats are different in their structures. And different habitats, they are different in the shape also, they are different in the size also. Structure, shape and size. Let us discuss about adaptation in plants in different habitats. So in this chapter, we are going to discuss in detail how the plants adapt to the different situations according to the structures, according to the shape and sizes they grow. Okay. Adaptation in plants. Like animal, plants also have also different in different places. They also are different in different places. They also does not respond the same. ये एक जैसे नहीं होते हर जगह. Desert plants are different from plants in the plains. जो desert plants होंगे उनके conditions अलग होंगे than the plants that are growing in the plains. जो plains पे होंगे सादा. Plants in forest are different from plants that grow in water. So plants that are growing in forest, they are having different features than plants that live in water. Plants have adaptations to help them live and grow in their habitats. The special features or the changes that allow plants to live and survive in a particular area is called adaptation. So what they describe as adaptation? The special features, the changes, that changes that allow the plants to live. टू लिव और जो अपने सराउंडिंग्स के हिसाब से जो अपने चेंजेस वो एडिप्ट कर सकते हैं, दे कैन सर्वाइव, दैट इज नोन एज अ एडेप्टेशन. आई होप दिस क्लियर. ओके. एडेप्टेशन इन प्लांट्स आर अकॉर्डिंग टू द हैबिटेट, प्रोटेक्शन एंड रिप्रोडक्शन. सो हाउ डू दे अकॉर्डिंग टू द हैबिटेट, अकॉर्डिंग टू द लिविंग, हाउ वी कैन प्रोटेक्ट देम एंड हाउ दे आर रिप्रोड्यूसिंग, दे आर प्रोड्यूसिंग देयर ऑफस्प्रिंग्स. इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल डिस्कस द प्लांट्स ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द हैबिटेट्स. In this chapter, what we are going to discuss, not on the basis of protection and reproduction, but in this chapter, we are going to discuss according to the habitats. Plants are classified into terrestrial and aquatic on the basis of their habitats. Like animals were classified, terrestrial animals that can live in, that live on land, and aquatic animals that live in water. So same is with the plants. Plants are also classified as terrestrial plants and aquatic plants. Terrestrial plants. Plants that grow on land are called terrestrial plants. So that grow on land. They are found in plains, example plains, mountain, deserts, marshy areas, forests, grasslands and in coastal areas. Coastal areas that are near the sea. Okay, coastal area, the Chennai, that are near the sea. Marshy areas, their forests are there, grasslands are there. The plants that are found here are known as terrestrial plants. Plants in the plains. So first we are going to discuss about the plants in the plains. In plains, the climate is neither too cold nor too hot. So in plains, like we are living, in the plains that we are living, the climate is neither too cold nor too hot. The plants that grow in this climate have lot of branches. So what is the speciality of the plants that grow here? उनकी बहुत सारी ब्रांचेज होती हैं. प्लांट शेड द लीव्स इन विंटर. ये अपनी लीव्स को शेड कब करते हैं? ड्यूरिंग द विंटर. मैंगो, गुलमोर एंड बैनियन ट्रीज आर द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ सच प्लांट्स. सो व्हाट आर द एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ द प्लांट्स इन प्लेन्स? मैंगो इज देयर, गुलमोर इज देयर, बैनियन ट्री इज देयर. ओके, नेक्स्ट. आई होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड द प्लांट्स इन प्लेन्स. So plants in plains are those which shed their leaves in winter and they have a lot of branches. Okay. Now we are moving forward to the plants in mountains or hilly areas. In the mountains, we all know mountains have generally have a cold type of climate. यहाँ पे बहुत ठंडा climate होता है. The climate is generally cold in mountains. There is snowfall in many areas. All some of the regions in the mountains are there that receives snowfall. Fir, pine and cedar are the examples of trees that grow on mountains. So what are the kind of different kind of trees that grow here? The different kind of trees that grow here are fir, pine and cedar. The conical shape of the tree. So what is the speciality? इनकी जो shape होती है cone जैसी होती है, जैसे ice cream का cone होता है ना बेटा, ice cream के cone जैसे इनकी shape होती है. The conical shape. Why they are having the conical shape? The conical shape of the trees allow the snow to slide off easy. So that because they are growing in the regions that receive snowfall, ये उस regions पे ज़्यादा होते हैं जब snow बहुत होती है. So because of the cone shape they are having, the snow cannot remain on the tree and it can slide off easily. The adaptations seen in trees are as follows. So what are the features, special features? Trees are tall, straight and cone-shaped. You can also see the pictures. Can you see the picture? Pine tree and fir tree. They are very tall, they are absolutely straight and they are cone-shaped. A few trees have needle-like leaves. How they are having leaves? They are having needle-like leaves. And most trees are evergreen. The meaning of the word evergreen are they remain green throughout the year. As the name suggests, they are green throughout the year. You can see the picture of the also of the pine tree and the fir tree. I hope it is clear. So some let's know more is also there. Let's see. Deciduous trees shed their leaves in winter to protect themselves from cold and new leaves appear again. So deciduous trees are the tree like the mountains in the plains. Like on the trees that are growing plain, they are usually of what kind? Deciduous. Because when they shed their leaves, they shed their leaves during the winter. Why? To protect themselves from the cold. And new leaves appear in when we switch season? In the spring season. And now evergreen trees, they do not shed their leaves at all. The speciality of evergreen trees are they do not shed their leaves and they remain green throughout the year. Okay, I hope it is clear. So this is important. You should learn the differentiate between deciduous trees and evergreen trees. Next, we have the plants in the desert. We all know deserts are very hot. Desert areas are hot, dry and sandy. It is full of sand. It is very hot. And in desert, the climate is very hot and dry. So plant needs to retain water and obtain water from deep inside the soil. So retain water में उनको अपना पानी बचा के रखना पड़ता है. And where they have to take the water from the deep inside the soil. उनको पानी soil के अंदर से लेना है. Like cactus is there, date palm, prickly pear and aponchia are the plants grow in desert area. So all the plants cannot grow. Like we say that some of the plants like other plants, mango and all, they cannot grow in desert area because they are not having the special features that these plants are having. उनके पास वो features नहीं है जो इन plants के पास हैं. Cactus, date palm, prickly pear, aponchia are the few plants that are growing desert area. So let us see what are the special adaptations that they are having. इनके पास क्या special adaptations होते हैं? We should discuss that. Most plants have spines instead of leaves. Spines prevent loss of water. So they are having spines. इनके leaves नहीं होते, they are having spines. And it prevents the loss of water. So water does not go out of the leaves. Like water is lost in the plants in the form of transpiration. Yes, transpiration एक process होती है जिससे जो पानी है, जो leaves में से पानी निकलता है. Now most plants have spines. इनके वो है ही नहीं, इनका leaves नहीं है. They are having spines, so they prevent the loss of water. So they can hold water for a long period of time. Plants have green fleshy stems that store water and have chlorophylls to make and store food. They are having very fleshy stems, they are very green, and first of all they are having chlorophyll. Chlorophyll is a substance that is required to make food, make and store food. So they can store food also and they can store water for time being. Okay, so these are the special features that they are having. Roots of the plants are long and spread out. You can also see the picture of cactus. They are not having leaves. In case see the spines here. एंड द रूट्स ऑफ द प्लांट्स दे आर वेरी लॉन्ग, ये बहुत बड़े होते हैं, दे आर वेरी लॉन्ग एंड दे आर स्प्रेड आउट, दे आर स्प्रेड आउट इन अ ह्यूज एरिया. सो दीज आर द अडेप्टेशंस दैट व्हाट काइंड ऑफ प्लांट्स आर हैविंग, प्लांट्स इन द डेजर्ट एरियाज. सो वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द प्लांट्स इन द माउंटेन रीजन्स, what they are having, plants in the mountain regions shed their leaves during the winter. And we have discussed about the plants in the, well, just for a second, plants in the mountain or the hilly areas. The specialty of this kind of this plants is that they are very cone shaped. Why they are cone shaped? Because because they grow in the snowy areas na, so that the snow slide off easily. And now last we have discussed about the plants that are growing in the desert area. Desert areas, they are having spines and they can have, they are very having green and fleshy stems, so they can store water. I hope it is clear. Okay, now we are moving forward to plant in the marshy areas. In marshy areas, the soil is clay and covered with water. The soil is very clay and it is almost covered with water. Roots of the plants do not get air. Jo roots hoti hai, jo jade hoti hai, they are not able to get proper air. So the roots grow out of the soil and water into the air. Kyunki inko andar se hawa nahi mil pa rahi hai. That's why the roots come above the ground. Why? And because to get water into the air. So the roots that grow out of the soil, jo soil se bahar nikalte hain, that these roots are called which kind of roots? These roots are called breathing roots. The trees having breathing roots are called mangroves. और जो ट्रीज के पास ब्रीथिंग रूट्स होते हैं दैट ट्रीज आर टर्म्ड एज मैंग्रोव. यू कैन सी द पिक्चर्स ऑल्सो, यू कैन सी द पिक्चर मैंग्रोव प्लांट्स विद ब्रीथिंग रूट्स. सी मैंग्रोव प्लांट्स इज देयर, दे आर इनसाइड द रूट्स ऑल्सो, इनकी जड़ें पानी के अंदर भी हैं एंड दे आर ग्रोइंग अबव द वॉटर ऑल्सो. वाई? बिकॉज दे आर नॉट एबल टू गेट प्रॉपर एयर, दैट्स वाई दे आर ग्रोइंग अबव द ग्राउंड. ओके, एंड रूट्स ऑफ द प्लांट डू नॉट गेट एयर, सो दे ग्रो आउट ऑफ द सॉइल. And these roots, the roots, can you see above the water? These roots are called breathing roots. Okay? And the plants and the trees, trees that are having breathing roots, that trees are termed as mangroves. I hope you have understood. Okay. Next we have the plants in the coastal areas. Coastal, that is basically near the sea. Coastal area receive a lot of rainfall. Lot of rainfall is there in the coastal areas. Moreover, water is also salty because they are near the sea. Like coconut plant is here, sugar cane is here, rubber plants are there in south. In south you can see many of the coconut plants. Sugar cane is here, rubber plants are seen in those region. Following are the adaptations seen in these trees. So can you see the adaptations? You can also see the picture of the coconut tree. What are the kind of adaptations, the special features they are having? They are long, strong and straight to withstand wind. They are very long. ये सीधे खड़े हो सकते हैं कि इनको विंड जैसे जब भी कभी तेज हवा चले ये झुके नहीं. दे आर वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग सो दैट दे कैन टॉलरेट द हार्श विंड दैट ब्लोस. हवा का जो कहते हैं बहाव है, हवा का जो इतनी जोर से जब हवा चलेगी ये उसको सह सकते हैं. दे आर वेरी लॉन्ग एंड स्ट्रॉन्ग. फ्रूट्स आर बिग एंड वाटर इन दैम. फ्रूट्स आर वेरी बिग दैट ग्रोस ऑन दैम एंड दे हैव अ लॉट ऑफ वाटर. Hairy and scaly leaves are found. They are having very scaly and hairy leaves. Lots of leaves are there. Can you see the pictures also? So scaly leaves are there in the coconut tree. So these are the adaptations of the plants in the coastal areas as they receive a lot of rainfall. Okay. Now we are discussing about the plants in the grasslands. What are the different kind of plants that grow in grasslands? These are the regions that do not receive sufficient rainfall. So plants in the grasslands are the region, they are not having proper sufficient rainfall. Rainfall नहीं होती है अच्छे से. They are mostly covered with grasses and a few trees. You can also see the picture ना, grassland. So they are already covered with grasses. इनके अपने पूरा grasses से और कुछ इनके यहाँ पेड़ होते हैं. These plants have extensive root system to prevent uprooting by grazing animals. So जो animals होते हैं जो ने graze है, जो इनकी घास खा ना जाए. But they are what to prevent them? They have narrow leaves that prevent water loss. इनकी जो leaves होती हैं वो काफ़ी narrow होती हैं जो इनका पानी वहाँ से नहीं निकले. और इनका एक root system भी क्या होता है, extensive होता है. So that जब animals इन्हें graze करने जाएँ ये वहाँ से uproot ना हो जाए. So these are the features of the plants in the grasslands. Okay? So in this video I am only discussing up to plants in the grasslands. So I hope you are trying to understand it. Go through my video carefully. Having any doubt you can ask. go through the each and every adaptation of each plants, how do the different plants adapt in different situations. In my next video, we shall continue with the next part of the chapter. Take a brief reading, okay?
Okay.
Now, till then, take care of yourselves. Goodbye.